Hello everyone, it's Axel from SEGGER. Today I want to talk to you about the Edit widget in AppWizard. The Edit widget is essentially a box where a user can enter information into your GUI. I have a super simple GUI here with just a screen and a box, and if I add the Edit object to it, then I get this box, I can position it, and if I try this out in play mode, I can click in it, and then I can actually start typing information into this box using my keyboard on my computer. Now, in a typical embedded device, you are most likely not going to have a keyboard connected to it. Most likely, you'll have to add a keyboard to your GUI, maybe using the keyboard object. But the keyboard object is a topic for another video. So let's cancel our play mode and take a look at the properties that are available for our edit object. The first one is set text that allows you to display some text initially when the edit object is first displayed. I'd like to skip over the decimal mode. I'll talk about that in just a little bit. By default, you're always adding characters to your edit box and not overwriting them. But if you activate overwrite mode, then existing characters will get overwritten when you type over them. There are several properties to change the look and feel of your edit box. For example, you can change the text color when the edit box is enabled or disabled, or for the cursor. Likewise, you can change the background colors, and you can set the frame color as well. So let's just play around with this a little bit. Let's say instead of white, I would like a yellow background color, and I want my frame color to be dark blue. Then my text box is going to change accordingly. Let's talk about the cursor inversion property. If cursor inversion is active, the color of the cursor is the inverted background color of the object. But you can disable that, and that allows you to pick a custom color for your cursor. By default, the blink period is 300 milliseconds. If you want that to be faster or slower, you can change that here. So now we have a pretty nervous cursor. So let's change that back. You have full control over the font that you would like to be displayed in your edit box. So we can change that to something bigger. And you can see that's really big. So now we should probably resize that object a little bit. Some other things you can change is the text alignment inside the object. You can change the inner gap, which is basically the spacing between the frame and the text. You can add a radius to your frame. For example, we can do 5. And then we have some rounded edges on our text box here. And that frame that we put in earlier that is really not very visible. So you can change the frame size as well. Just like that. You can specify the maximum number of characters. So for example, if you don't want the user to go over 10, then you could do that like so. And after 10 characters, I can't add anymore. So that's essentially it if you want to use this edit object for text input. But you can also use it to enter numbers. So when you use the edit object in decimal mode, you can come down here and specify a range. So you can say, I want to accept numbers between 0 and 9999. And then those are the numbers that are being accepted. So let's take a look at which interactions are available for our edit widget. So let's add an interaction for our edit box. And here you can see all the signals that the edit box can emit. For example, it can signal that enter has been pressed. And then here are all the actions you can take when that signal is being emitted. If you simply wanted to pick up the value of this edit box in your user code, you could simply say null. That will give you a slot routine in your code for when enter has been pressed in your edit box. And you can add the code that should be executed in that case right here in AppWizard, or of course you can add that in the IDE you're using for developing the rest of your code. So in a nutshell, that's what I wanted to tell you about the edit object. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please also check out our other videos on AppWizard, and thanks for watching.